the Lesnar fight in the cage was a big story. What did you think about what he did afterwards with the stand-up and the fingers and all that stuff?
Well, first of all, flipping off the crowd is never a good thing to do. You know, especially if you want your money. But I think right now he's just trying to play that that role of being the bad guy of UFC, you know. You know, Tito was supposed to be the bad boy of UFC, and he's left now, and we really don't have one. And I think Brock Lesnar's trying to take Tito's spot. And after his fight with Frank Mir, he did a pretty good job of taking that role.
Anthony Johnson with us from the UFC. So what do you think of Lesnar's performance? Because, I mean, I thought the guy was really good, but then when you start adding, you know, technique and strategy on the ground, I mean, that was ridiculous to watch one guy pin a 245-pound dude's left arm on the ground and just smash him in the face.
I mean, I wasn't impressed by it, but, I mean, of course he got the job done. To me, Lesnar's only winning because he has potential. Of course he's an athlete, but he's still very green to the sport, you know, and right now he thinks he's the big thing in UFC, you know, just because of his name in WWF back in the day. I wasn't impressed by his performance. I mean, anybody can hold somebody down and just hit him. You know, he didn't do anything special at all. You know, Frank Mir just made a mistake and got himself in trouble, and, you know, that's what you don't want to do during a title fight, you know, especially against a big guy like Brock Lesnar. He'll use that size and strength and power to his advantage, and that's what he did. You know, Frank Mir isn't a small guy either, but, man, you don't find too many people bigger than Brock Lesnar. And like I say, he just used everything that he had to his advantage, but it wasn't impressive. I mean, his stand-up didn't do anything to make anybody say ooh and ah, and his ground and pound didn't make anybody say ooh and ah. I mean, the fight was boring, you know what I mean?
Say not anybody, because if anyone could do it, we would all go, well, not, I'm not a fighter, but you would go in there, get a guy down and hold down his left arm. His ground and pound, he got off like 40 unanswered shots in the first, and the guy couldn't move.
Yeah, I mean, I still wasn't impressed by anything. He hasn't did anything for the sport, and he hasn't did anything for me or really the fans to say, you know, good job, you know.
Right,
like I said, Brock Lesnar, Frank just got caught. He just made a simple mistake, and Brock is not as stupid as people think he is, and he capitalized on it.
See, this is interesting because I kind of ripped Lesnar a little bit over the last couple of days for his antics after the fight. But some of his defenders have said, well, part of it is the frustration that he's had from guys within the sport who have absolutely no respect for him whatsoever. And you're kind of making that sound like it's the case. He's the heavyweight champ.
He's what? Good.
He's the champ.
He ain't legit. What makes him legit? Because he beat Frank Mir?
Yes. That's very legit.
He beat Frank Smith in the first round. Then the second round, they gave him Heath Herring. You know, and then they gave him Brandy. You know, that man didn't deserve a title shot after his third fight. There's so many guys that's been in the UFC that have been working their ass off, and he comes in and has two fights, and all of a sudden he gets the number one guy. He's not that good. He's not that special. You
all
know
right.
what I mean? Put him up against Shane Carwin or what's his name?
Cain Velasquez.
Cain Velasquez. He'll get demolished himself.
Okay. I will argue with you, though, Anthony. I think you're going to realize that Lesnar at UFC 100, acting the way he did, getting it on more mainstream television than it had been on before, actually does help you.
Well, it helps the business, of course.
Yeah.
It helps the business, but to me, it didn't help anything else, you know? It brought UFC more money, yeah.
Well, eventually they can turn it around and give it to you.
Might
be a while before that happens, but you got to keep winning.
Yeah, of course.
Hey, so I want to get your take on George St. Pierre in the 170 division. First off, there are rumors now that he may be injured pretty seriously, and he may be out like 6, 9, 12 months. So is that a good thing for the 170 division? How do you think they handle that?
Well, I think even without George St. Pierre, the 170 division is going to be stacked no matter what. I mean, he's not the reason why 170 is the way it is. I mean, he makes it exciting, and yeah, he's the champ, but you got guys that, yeah, he's already beat, but these guys are coming back better and stronger than before, you know. And you got a lot of up-and-comers that are coming in very good. So I think the 170 division is still going to be the best division in UFC. So, I mean, it's not going to bring our division down, and our division is still going to be the number one division, and it's still going to be exciting.
Anthony Johnson with us. It's Steve and Dave. Whack 'em Wednesday. Anthony fights at 170 pounds, welterweight division. He fights in the same class as George St. Pierre. Because I don't know how much you follow the internet, and I know people go nuts, but this is even the normal media. Some of the reaction after George St. Pierre wins that I hear, and even I think Dana does it too, where it's like, oh, this division, there's no one there. That's got to set you off. I mean, it's like, what? The next fight could be Martin Campman, Mike Swick. What, they're garbage? No one else is on the way. How old are you now, Anthony? You're 24?
25.
What do you think when you hear that, when people are like, well, there's no one in the world who's even close to George St. Pierre?
I let the people talk, you know what I mean? I'm like, I try to be like Dan Henderson, even though I do have a big mouth. You know, I try to let my fist do the talking. But, I mean, it's that GSP will lose eventually, but I can't say when. You know, he hasn't fought me, so I can't say when he's going to lose. I think Mike Swick will give him a run for his money. I think anybody and everybody he faced from now on is really going to give him a run for his money, no matter how long he's out or no matter how long that he stays, you know, healthy. I mean, he's going to have to fight to keep that title no matter what.
Anthony is a part of a cool charity golf tournament, kind of like our charity that we've got going on July 24th. This one's on August 11th. You're actually going to get a chance down in the Southern California area. You can go check out the info at MMAagents.com. It's going to be in the San Bernardino area, and it's for the benefit of Ryan Bennett, who was a MMA media member who got in a car accident and passed away. This benefits his family. It's a cool golf tournament. You get a chance to play with a fighter in your foursome, and again, you can get all the information. It's August 11th. They're going to be playing at Sierra Lakes Golf Club in Fontana, California. It's at MMAagents.com. Back to GSP for a second. So how would you stay off the mat? Because clearly that's the test now, is not getting tackled and held down and beaten upon by George St. Pierre, because I think he scored like 9 out of 11 takedowns. His takedown rate is like the best in the history of the UFC. So what would you do?
I would do a lot of things. You know, of course, you know, you can't pressure a guy like GSP, you know what I mean? As soon as like this, every time Thiago put pressure on him, he got taken down. You know, you got to, and plus, you know, he had those little arms and that disadvantage for the, as far as reach. You know, Thiago's was 70 and GSP's was 76. So, you know, you got to have a better game plan than just straight Muay Thai. You got to get in and really stand and keep a lot of pressure on him as far as being that short like Thiago was, you know, and be ready for the sprawl because you know he's going to shoot. And I don't think GSP likes to get hit. He doesn't like confrontation, you know what I mean? He doesn't want to make too much contact, but he's a fighter, you know. He's smart, you know, and he'll do what he has to do to win, and I respect him for that.
All right, my co-host is giving me a look like, what do you mean he doesn't want to get hit? I kind of agree with it. He got knocked out by Matsera. He fights smart now, but I don't know that he wants to stand there and strike with guys.
That's not his
game. Well, you never see him really come out of a fight with any scratches because he'll take you down, you know what I mean? But he will hit you. But if you hit him back, to me, I think it's like trouble for him. You know what I mean?
Yep.
He doesn't want to mess up his pretty little face. And, you know, in this sport, you got to get ugly sooner or later.